Hi students, today we are going to see the discuss the topic of fatigue. What is mean fatigue? Fatigue is a cyclic load applied to the material cosmetic. It may be tensile, it may be compressive, or tensile-compressive. Normally, in all the practical applications, we look for fatigue failures. Right? Because it is a dynamic, cyclic load is applied to the material. Example, if you take bridge, aircraft, ship, of all machine components are fatigue failure. Because we are applying the cyclic load. Fatigue failure is brittle, like relative to brittle plastic deformation. Even though it is brittle material, the brittle it will have a little plastic deformation, like a brittle. This will be a sudden and catastrophic failure. Applied stress of causing the fatigue may be axial, as I said, that because tension or compressive or flexible. Flexible means it will have a tension and compressive. Fatigue failure presents three different stages. First, crack initiation and the areas of stress concentration. Stress concentration normally you have a curvature portion, you have stress concentration will be more. Then incremental crack propagation and final catastrophic failure. These are the stages of fatigue failure. This is the output of any fatigue machine. Right? If you conduct any fatigue test, this is a wave will be produced. That is we call as a stress wave. We call it as a SN curve. And the output of a fatigue curve, you get a curve we call as a SN curve. This is a curve which is called as stress, time versus stress. You have these are the stresses which is produced by alternately. You have a tension, compression, tension, compression, tension, compression. This will be random, it is periodic, it will be periodic zero and successful. This is the main important parameter. First, we have mean stress. You have to calculate the mean stress. Maximum stress, or by minimum, we add with the maximum plus minimum, you get by 2, you get the minimum stress. The range of stress we can get is sigma maximum minus sigma minimum. Stress amplitude, stress amplitude is the maximum amplitude that the stress will get out. Sigma A is equal to sigma R divided by 2, sigma maximum minus sigma minimum divided by 2. R is the stress ratio, R is equal to sigma minimum divided by sigma maximum. These are the fatigue test machine. We have a rotary bending test machine. We have a bearing housing and bearing housing. This is the coupling, which is a high speed motor. Initially, we keep the specimen in the bearing housing. In the high speed, we have a rotary motion. Then here we will have a load. One will be a tension, another will be compression. If the specimen is rotating, at the same time the load will be applied. After applying the load, yes, you will get as previously I said that. Output of the fatigue is SN curve, stress to the number of cycles. This will be output of, there will be x-axis will be number of cycles, y-axis will be stresses. This is the stress, we call as a number of cycles, we call it as a stresses. Number of cycles we have 10 power 3, always in the fatigue data you have a logarithmic scale. Why we are not drawing the logarithmic scale? The huge data we cannot draw in normal scale and you cannot get the data clear. In logarithmic, you will get a time consuming will be very high. Even though fatigue test will contain 24 hours, 48 hours, based on hours only will be conducted. This is an example fatigue curve for titanium alloy. This is the number of cycles, this is the stress amplitude, where the maximum stress can be. Fatigue, we have a low cycle fatigue, high cycle fatigue, and medium cycle fatigue. Up to 10 power 3, we call it as a low cycle. 10 power 3 to 10 power 6, we are called as a low cycle. Medium cycle, then 10 power 6 to 10 power 9 is higher fatigue. This is the three stages of fatigue failure. First, the crack initiation will occur in the stress concentration area, then incremental of crack propagation, then rapidly to be propagated. This is the stages of fatigue failure inside the range.